If you've turned it down and can't feel it no more, some places between here and Dunmore, where I live, there's a foundation put up. They laid block for a building, but it's been sitting there for years and years. And every time I go by, I think something bad wrong happened there. My friend, on up the road just a mile or two, I see a man pour concrete out, laid a foundation up, built his house up. But the ground that he did it on, it's washed out around it. He's had to pile up dirt and patch it up, my friends, to keep from the foundation busted up. Bless his name. my friend, and God has visited and redeemed his people, and he redeemed them. He's the Redeemer. And yes, Job's fulfillment come to pass when he said, I know that my Redeemer liveth and will stand in the latter day. Oh yes, my friend, Christ is God's Redeemer for mankind. You can't get it fixed. You can't get yourself fixed any other way. And you've got a disease that's worse than all three that I made. And that's sin. It separates you from the camp of the living God. What is the camp? It's the church here on earth today. That's his camp to the devil. In Revelation 20, it's a make of war with the devil. He's not making war of a sinner people out here. He has gathered his forces to battle against the camp of the saints, the Bible says. That's you and I. My friend, listen. Oh, but he already knows what his end is. The devil already knows. He's already had his head bruised. The Christ has already put his foot on his head and put him in his place. And if we follow Christ, we can do the same thing. The devil cannot take you out of the hand of our Savior. He's not got the authority, my friend. His beast, his false prophet, they can't reach you. If you're kept by the gospel, it'll keep you. If you want to be kept, my friend, listen. When Jesus, the hour let the clock run away, my friend. But Jesus, when he was born, came to 30 years old, began to be up and about his father's business. He started healing the sick, raising the dead, open blinded eyes. And shortly after his ministry began, who come to him? The old leper. Was supposed to be outside, away from everybody, hollering unclean. But what did he do? He come right to where Jesus was. A great multitude around him. He wasn't hollering unclean. The time is coming to a change. The old is getting ready to vanish away. And behold, but God the Lord, he's making everything new. But by a new and a living way, where grace is given to everybody, but to the Jew first and then to the Greek. Bless his name. I love what he told the apostle in the Great Commission. You shall be witnesses of me, both in Judea and where else? In Samaria. Where else? Into the uttermost parts of the earth. But why did the heathen rage and the people imagine main things? It's because God is working a new thing out on behalf of all people, everywhere, every tribe and family of the earth. The old male leper, he came down the road into the crowd, walked up to Jesus. He didn't holler unclean. He didn't stay away from the crowd. And I'll tell you, the crowd didn't push him out like they was commanded. I'm telling you, the law is a lot different than the grace of God. And our nature, it'll tell us to sin away. But the grace and the love of God will cause us to draw nigh to each other and to the Father. For he's in us and us in him. We're all one in Christ Jesus. That was the 17th chapter of John. That's the real Lord's Prayer. It's for us to all be one, Tony. No separation. No big eyes. No use. No reason for me to put a big robe on and put a cloak about my neck and act like I'm bigger than you. The man in bibbed overalls is just as good in the sight of God than the most well said, I will. Be thou whole. Look how he took care of that. The same thing with the woman. She could have been put to death. My friend, listen. It ain't no different with us. Everyone deserves to die. And Christ fixed it for us. That's what he did. He healed the woman. And she went on her way. What about the dead being defiled? He was on a journey when that took place. He didn't want to know what he was left to do. He was a going to see somebody that was dead. And yet he took time out to heal her. God is able here tonight. If somebody is dead, he's able to heal one, a save one, raise the dead. He can work from the front to the back. He ain't got no restrictions on him. He is love, pure love, through and through. He's got all power, knows all things, knows everything about you. But my friends, you can't hide nothing from God. Bless his name. On his way to raise the dead. What he do? He's supposed to tend the dead. They said that he kept the law to the letter. That's what the Bible says. That he kept the law to the letter. And the letter was the Torah. Watch about tempting dead people. There's a change coming. Jesus never shied away from Jairus' daughter. What did he do? He went in. And the people, he told them, this little girl ain't dead. She's asleep. And you want to know what they did? They laughed at him. And they mocked our Lord. And you see it everywhere today. The Satan, the cult club. They're making fun of the Christians. The atheists. They're sitting up there. The little things beside. The nativity scenes. In our public squares. In front of our stores. In courthouses. Because they've got freedom of speech. My friends, they can do what they want to. But God don't allow them to be just as evil as they want to be. But I got news for them. God will have the final say so, my friends. And in every atheist that's pulling those tricks today, every one of them will bow their knee and they will confess that Jesus is the Son of God. And every satanic follower in this world, he'll have to look at his father, the devil, and say, you lied to me. God is the truth. I should have followed him. My friend, listen. The choices in this life have great consequences. And your choice is going to be for life everlasting. For you're going to go with the crowd that's reserved in chains of darkness to the great day of God's wrath. Into that little girl he went. Went up to her, said, maid, arise. And up she come. She was dead now, and she's alive now. Do you want to know what else? Walking along there, here's a little woman. She's a widow woman. I don't know if you all know it or not, but Christ really loves widows and orphans here. In so much that he told us brethren here, the true and undefiled religion before God and the Father is to visit the widows and the orphans in their afflictions. I can holler amen, amen. But right here's one that ain't done enough of it. We all should have no idle time on our hands. If you're idle, you're doing the devil's work. If you're idle, we should be. And there's always something to do if you're a child of God. And to keep ourselves unspotted from this world. My friend, listen. He went along. Here's a little widow. Don't y'all look the clock now. I know it's getting close. But that really don't matter. He may come before I get there. And I've been wanting to go. But when he comes, I hope to God I'm a preacher somewhere. But when he comes, it'd be so easy to just start grinning and laughing and just go on. Bless his name. A little woman, he looked at the little mother, and she was weeping and a crying because her only son died. My God, today, my friends, you talk about a man with compassion. We'll never be able, no matter how hard we try, we'll never be able to demonstrate it to the fullness of our Master. He walked up to the little woman, and he looked at her, and he had compassion on her, and he walked over to the box that her boy was buried in. And reached out and touched him. And he raised up from the dead. Oh, my friend, listen. Oh, why on earth did us brother keep telling you about all these miracles that Christ done? But we can't do them. I can't do them. The Pope can't do them. Billy Hinn can't do them either. And all the rest of them fools and deceivers of the Word of God that you're looking and you're listening to. But turn them off. But get away from them. But find you a gospel minister that'll cut you to the heart with the Word of God. And he'll help you to get out of fire. That's what will happen. All the rest of them is interested in money and power and prestige. That's what it is. But Christ did all these miracles that he may prove to the people that he was the Son of God.
Amen.
And there was, we talk about people who didn't believe him, but there were many that did. There were multitudes that did. They brought in, I don't believe there's a fraction wrote down in that book of the number of miracles that he did. I don't believe there but just a speck of how many he did. Because if it had all been written, we'd have still been reading just the miracles that he did. Because they brought him multitudes, by the hundreds, maybe even more at a time, come to him everywhere he went. I never found nowhere in the lids of this book that he turned one of them away. I've not found it. But he did that to prove to them that he was sent from God. And that the words that he was speaking what God gave to him. And it said he did these miracles that people would believe that he was the Son of God. And if people would believe that, they could be saved through his name. Now, you may say, well, if you all could still do that, it'd be easier for me to believe it and come up with it. That's just another lie that you're allowing yourself to believe, friends. Because God's done something that's more powerful than me going up and raising Jairus' daughter. He's doing something today more powerful than that woman reaching out and touching the hem of his garment. He's doing something more powerful, more miraculous than open blind Bartimaeus' eyes. What in the world's that? I ain't seen it, Tommy. You see all these people here? We were dead, and now we're alive.
Amen.
We were in darkness, and now we're children of light.
Amen.
We were lost, but now we're found. He can take you tonight, and when you begin to believe this, this story that we're preaching will become the power of God down inside of your life, and it will transform you from a world of sin and iniquity and cleanse you and purge you and make you white and clean and pure and washed in the sight of Almighty God, and you can have 100% fellowship with Him right here, right now. Bitch, I'll be. We ain't got no miracles to do tonight, except tell you one that will do one if you'll believe his word. Now, if you don't believe it, you'll go right on through this life, and the next thing you know will be depart from me into a lake that burns far away. But if you'll believe it, you'll find joy unspeakable and full of glory. And you'll go home tonight and you'll lay down. best night's sleep you've ever had.
Yeah.
Knowing that if you never wake, you never breathe another breath in this life, that we'll enter into a city that Paul and John seen, and they referred it to it as the third heaven. I like what John said in there too. He raised up his hand and pointed in that direction. And he said, there'll not be none of this over there. I'm going to go there if nobody else does. But every child of God here in this house tonight, some friends, they want you to go too. That's just the way it is. They want you to come and go too. But we can't make you. We're not going to try. Christ won't make you. God won't make you. He gave you that choice. But if you do, it mean enough to him and bring him enough glory to pull you up out of the pit of sin and set your feet on a solid rock. Establish your comings and your going. Be a light to the way you travel, your feet, your path in life. And get lighted up and show you the way. That's what little David said. God bless you. It's been a pure pleasure to preach to you tonight. The only thing that made it even better.